components have RAM or random access memory. Your notebook computers have random access memory, meaning that if you can, any circuit which can make which can keep the memory. Sometimes we use what we call the reset set flip flops. So now we go to the section of, I hope I am sure. We ended that F is equal to 1 over T, and the frequency of the welcome dot has set by gram. So we now go to flip flops. So if, in a computer, there is nothing magical. It's all about the circuits which are put together, and then they keep remembering. So like, you know, when you are opening Word, you go to Start if you are using Windows, and then it opens the Start menu. You go to Programs, then you go to Microsoft Office, then you go to Word. After going to Word, then you can play around, edit, save, you know, bold, resize, EDC. You cannot, when you want to go back, you go backwards. I think they taught you that in computer. So electronics is like the basis of the computing. Just like you, when you are dressing, at least for me guys, before you put on a vest, put on a shirt, put on a tie, put on a coat. You cannot undress by undressing the vest first. You have to come to the last one to put on. Put off. The ladies can always maneuver. They may put on a bra and then remove it even before they remove the bra. So I can't use ladies for an example. But for us, you have to remove the coat, then I remove the tie, then I remove the shirt, then I remove the vest. So this flip-flops help us in making memory circuits. Circuits that can have a previous state, a past state, also remembered. So a flip-flop is a device that can store a binary digit. And such a binary digit, we call it a bit. And a bit, one bit, equals how many bytes? 8 bytes.
Try again.
And then you form a byte, 8 bytes. So a bit, you have a mega, a kilobyte, a kilobyte. Or sometimes we just say KB. You have a megabit. These days we have gigabit. We have gigabits. And now I have a terabyte.
Zero.
And what is next to this?
Zero.
So the bistable meaning two states, or giving you two stable states. The bistable multiplier, I brought the camera knowing that being the last lecture almost, you'll be funny, so saying I'm controlling comfortably. Whatever you say now, when I'm reviewing, I don't know whether it is the calculator. So the bistable multiplier is the basic storage element. You remember when those who did it, you would have Q bar. And you wouldn't have this one doing this twice and then going this way. You would always remember, I have to go this way. I have to go this way. It wasn't. And that's how the traffic lights work, if you remember.
who have been coming on for some time goes off, orange warns the motorists, red goes on, they stop, and then another side, green goes on, they go, orange warns them, then red stops them, and that sequence goes. So those who are from town going to Wandegeya, they allow them to go. Then after some time, those who are going to Mulago, they go. After some time, then it stops again for the ones of Wandegeya to go. And then the sequence, that memory keeps on going. But its contents, its contents cannot be changed. This is like an example I've just given of how we apply the brain. You cannot remember them. You cannot change them. It's a sequence. They keep going, keep going. So if that is not the case, or if we can't do that, we can apply a set free flow, what we call an RSFF. And we can implement this using two types of gates. We can use the NAND gates, or we can use the NOR gates. So before I actually talk about it, I need to first give you the circuit symbol. Circuit symbol of a set flip flop. So you just draw a box. Is this a box or I don't know whether it is a rectangle, whether it is a square, but you write this box and you have one of the inputs being a reset, the other being a set, and then you have the outputs as the likely state, the unlikely state. And where S is set input, R is reset input, Q and Q bar or Q negation, these are complementary. When the other one is high, the other one should be low. When it becomes high, this one also becomes low. So that's why we call them complementary outputs. Now, so we can implement the set set, but the simple example of set reset is like you've seen these digital radios, the radios without, they are. I was supposed to bring my radio here, but you know these radios where there is a pointer inside here with 88.2104.7, and then you have your knob here on the side. I mean, this is your radio, okay? And you have a knob here for the tuning the channels, you have the volume here. And this one here is the one amplified to this. So you turn, you go when you are at 104.7 to listen to 88.7, 88.2, you have to go very far this side. But now when you're using your mobile phone FM stations, your FM radio, you don't hassle. You press the search button, it scrolls through. After scrolling through, then you can start playing each of them at will. Or you can use the star button, and then when you are in media, then you choose the channel you want by typing in the keys you want, and then you go to the channel you want. You want to set them, you will say to go back. But there are also these small radios, very tiny.
Tiny of this size, with a radio there, they have a speaker there, and then they have batteries here on the side. You put in the batteries, there are two batteries. One is set, the other one is reset. So one you can use it to look for channels around. Reset takes you to the beginning channel. So that's the application of the reset set, for example. So we can implement the reset set flip-flop using a null get, sorry, null gets, and how we draw it, we have our two null gets here. We have the reset here, then we have this going to this other side, part of the output being put back into the input. And then you have this other side, and then you have the set, just like a feedback circuit we have. So for example, if you had two nodes and you are having the other one output here going back to the other place here in order to get a tune, it means you keep remembering that if it, what came was not, it will again be made yes, I mean high, and then becomes a low again, and then sent back. So if you can have a bunch of gates, a lot of them, then you can do a lot of memory keeping in your circuit. The truth table of such a flip-flop, we shall have our set inputs, and then you get the next state, Q, N plus 1, when it was off, sorry, when it was low, what would be the next thing? It means if this was low, for example, here becomes high, this one makes it low again, and then you take that low back here. If it was low, now here it would be made high, and then you are now on the next step. That is why we have the Qn plus 1, the next step. And then I will have these ones, now you are used to them, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. If it is when you have both of them, when they are low, you have the initial state, otherwise here you'll be having, when you put in the set, when you set, you get a channel. So when your set is high, you get the channels coming up. If you reset, they all go back to zero. You take the channels to zero. I'm just using an example of the radio for that matter. Then you have this one right here. But you cannot do reset and set at the same time, can you? It is impossible. So this one here, you normally say that it is not allowed. You can't reset and set at the same time. You have to do one at a time. So this is not allowed. It is not allowed state. This state can't be detected. Otherwise it is unstable. Try to have your radio on phone and reset and reset. There is no way you can do it. And if you have ever tried to look for channels, auto-scan, and then as it is scanning, your TV is scanning, you want to stop it or cancel. There is no canceling, you have to relax. Or maybe you can run to the wall and switch off.
But it will wait. You will have to wait for it to put the looking for channels after them, then tries to arrange them, and then you delete some you don't want later. We can also use the all gates. In other words, when you have the this one is hard. If you look at this other truth table of ours, you have this one, no signal, no signal. So you have in the zero here and zero there. And when you bring it to this, what comes out here? If you have the zero and the zero here, what do you get here? Or what would be this state? What would be these two states here? Because all we are doing is to implement this truth table using these gates here. You have done all this in the lab. You had the LEDs, you made them light. Some of you used theory when I was not there, and then you got the thing. But I've already marked B1, B2, B14, and E1. I'm left with the others. Don't be scared. So what comes out of here? If I have this one as a zero, then what is here? What comes out of here? It doesn't matter what is here. It's if you have a zero here, it must be a one, which would have gone here. And also a one would come. And so what would be your, you have a one here. For 0, 0, you can't have one as your output for your Qn plus one. You get the first state. And then when you give this one a zero and here a one, of course you are sure you're getting a high. If you put in a reset, you reset, it means you have, it's like you have wrapped everything now. So you don't expect any value. But you shouldn't be so obsessed with the interpretation of this truth table versus the diagram. You should be more interested in how these few blocks are used in memory circuits, basically. After all, you were having chips. Did you see the gates inside? You were relying on the map and relying on the legs, which are for input and for output. And then you did your stuff and it came out. And that with, I think, about four. Each of them had four gates, isn't it? Were they four or one, two, three, then minus one for grounding, minus one for VSO top. So there were four gates. But you couldn't realize there are four gates in one simple, small chip. Then if we are using the NAND gates, or you can say, yes. The meaning of?
Qn.
Okay, if I using like your calculator, I've used your calculator in finding and in working out an equation, for example, y is equal to ax plus c, and or the quadratic equation. You put in the equation and you keep pressing to the value. Press gives you the value. You don't have to hit again. That is the first one you put, that for example you will get a Qn, put in the next value, it gives you n plus 1. Because what we are now getting towards is having sequential. Remember, this one gives you sequential circuits compared to the ones which only depended on the present states of logic gates. But now this one gives you a sequence. you had put this, now the next one. So if you go to step 2n, the next one will be 2n plus 1. Next one you, is now 2n plus 1 plus the other one. So that's how, well, that's why we have 2n here.
So if we are to use the nums, I have my two nums here. Please watch how I draw them. You draw them in a test. I mean, I'm not sure whether this test will be more of an LA drawing of the gates. But in exam, if you draw these gates and you start drawing me that this is a nun. Yeah, we'll answer. I am trust. I mean, I tell the true stories, you know. And then students accuse me that I get pride from failing people. I don't know. My self-esteem comes from somewhere else, not from seeing my brothers and sisters and my children failing. So we have Q, Q bar, and then we shall enter the negative values. Not set and not. But we can also have the reset set flip flop and enable it. Like give it a square wave. And when we give it a square wave, what do you guys eat? And sometimes you might find that you do that. Do you spend time on Facebook in the night? When I'm going home, I normally leave a bunch of students here still on the steps accessing the internet. And I don't see them, any of them on Google, let's say, looking for notes, but they are just on WhatsApp. I'm not doing that again. And you can imagine, on Facebook and what I think mostly WhatsApp, they are very active, very attentive. They are waiting for the next message. But where is that? And you can't get anything from WhatsApp. But from where you get an A? Oh yes. Yeah, those are the ones I'm talking about. I'm not talking about you. Of course, you can't risk being there. You cannot risk being there when I'm passing. And then you accept me to see you doing that on WhatsApp. But you're also doing somewhere else. Yeah, you know that. So we can enable. Instead of getting these other values here from our outputs here, we can instead put here a block, put here pulse, okay, to enable our flip flop. I'm sure the groups, all of you, the Friday group and the yesterday group, I was impressed. I made sure I'm there to see each and every group. I'm sure you saw me on your practical, and it was nice because now I could explain or talk about what we're doing because we had covered it. So I don't know how, if you have a dad or uncle who is a policymaker or is rich, you should tell them to buy for us more equipment. Each of your dads bought an oscilloscope and donate it to us. We will have the lab full of oscilloscopes and all of you will do free one at the beginning. You can do it. Your dads drive nice cars and live in nice mansions, isn't it? On loan. Okay, RS with enable. With enable, and what I mean here with enable is that we have the nuns, like
we had at the beginning, and then instead of the on this part we put what we call a flock, see? And then we have the S, R, and then we have our this one. So we, this one we plant it here. So that I have this, giving the input this other part. Circuit symbol for this are the reset set flip flop with the neighbor. You draw the box as we had, or rectangle as we had it. You have your outputs at Q and Q bar. The complemental outputs, and then you have your three inputs: the set, the reset, and the pulse. And the pulse is the clock. Oh, we level this one inside here. We follow. So we can get a truth table. On the truth table, we have the states. S, R, C, then you have Q, N plus 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. And then clock. You have another state past 1, 1, whereby you have the XX, so you have your clock being enabled high, and then you have no, when you have no enabling taking place. So the we have the other state of QN. We have 0, then we have reset being 1, and we have everything going to 0. And then when we have the reset being high, becomes 1. And then when the, both of them are reset and set, then you don't expect to have anything. We say it is not allowed. And then the other one, the last one becomes the initial state. When you had not put in anything, it's the same as when you are. So X is not allowed. I mean star, not X. So there is another one which they call a D flip-flop, and we, because this one helps us to amass data, it is called a data latch. So a data latch flip-flop, where D is a data latch, data latch. This eliminates the unstable state. This eliminates the unstable states. X means that you are not putting anything. There is a difference between, I think it is those who are doing D2,
yesterday,
where I remember when I came and we had not connected the inputs to anything, and maybe to it, and I think there was a mistake. It meant that, it doesn't mean that if you don't put in anything, that then that is a zero state, a low state. It's like having your probes of the oscilloscope not connected, the ground is not put, and you say after all it is ground, then it is not doing its function. When you ground, it means you are like for our DL logic, okay? Our diode logic, when we have the 5 volts here, plus, and then we have the diode here, and then we were expecting to have our output here, and our input here, okay? If you were to, this is V out, this was V in. If you were to put here, to leave this one hanging, then you wouldn't have this 5 flowing anywhere. So you will never get any state here. That's the idea, the concept of having excess there. Having excess there means nothing is being put. And not similar to when I'm putting in low. The low, for those of you who have done D1 and D2, low means that you are putting in the ground. You are grounding the place. So this eliminates the unwanted states. Sorry, not unstable, but unwanted. Not allowed. Unwanted states. When was this? When do we get unwanted states? Unwanted means not allowed. So when do we get that? When R equals S equals to 1. And that is by making R to be equal to, so that they can never be the same. Remember in electricity and magnetism, when we are looking for the work done due to the an arrangement of charges, where you have to make sure that I can never be equal to J, so that there is no replication of the force. So that means we can implement this, but make sure that R equals S is negated. So we put here a not get, so that we invert it. A not get is also called an inverter. So I will have the other NAND get, then I have the NAND get down here. Then I put here an inverter for a not get. And if I have the set here, then I'll be having this other side as the reset, but which reset equals to S inverter. So I draw this one from there, put it there, and then I will have the flop here. Putting here a dot here means that you are clearly showing that this one is connected, these two are not connected. So this is now the clock, and this would be S prime. And then I add this other part here, which is a NAND there. And then I draw the other side of it. Then we have Q and Q bar. All this structure can be reduced to a circuit symbol, which is
a rectangle with a D and with a C and a Q and a Q bar. So this whole part here, this other part here, is the one which is going for our D, our data latch, and then the clock here gives us this other part on our circuit symbol. Truth table. We got the D, C, 2n plus 1. So we have when the whole of S and S bar being not available, and then we have the clock being 0 when there's no enabling. That is the first state. When we have the D 0 and clock enabled, we get the 0 output, or the 0 not output per se, but the result. And when they are both high, this time we get a 1, because, sorry, not both high, but when this is high, which constitutes the D part, and then the clock is enabled, then you get the result being 1. The next one is the edge-triggered flip-flops. You must have seen the one trigger on the oscilloscope. Although we didn't really have much, I thought you would have learned the oscilloscopes in the first year. Made the Lesogev figures and the like, so that I only use it in the third year, I would be using it to do things, but I didn't find that possible. Edge triggered flip flops. The flip-flop changes state. The flip-flop changes states, or changes state, when R equals to S equals to 1.
Cycle in a second.
Yes.
What is that? What do you mean by the log in your room?
The what?
That's it. When you are drawing the crude pencil, because of the seeing the clock, what does this mean that you do?
The clock is this one. The clock is our pulse. So when it is high, when it is here, this is high. And when it is here, this is the zero. So when we are low, high, low, high. And when we are here, this is the much time we spend when it is high. So the rising edge, when we say edge trigger, it means when it is rising, then you have your free flow being activated, as being made to do something. When it is falling, also made, it is made to do something. And then it's the time, the what I've been doing here dancing around is how long it takes when it is high, then it becomes low, becomes high, low. And that's what we mean by something being periodic. It was like your strikes are periodic. Every semester, how long it takes, how long you are in chaos is a different matter. Is this one here. Maybe I can use strikes, you don't understand them, but so every semester is great. That is now you are having the periodic function of your strikes. Every semester they are there. How long they take and how many times do you have them is the frequency. What else can I use to explain about this pulse? So the clock is this pulse you are having. This one. In some books you find that the clock is represented by a God as you are bringing in your pulse. Because that pulse helps you to trigger either high or low. Just like when you are wave shaping, you are using your pulse. And then you now make your pulse when you are using the part of the capacitor. Then you start shaping it, you start chopping part of it, chopping part of it. Chopping part of it because of the charging and the discharging within the capacitor, the RC factor. So at only the rising changes state output, at only the rising edge. When it is rising is when you have the changes, and that means the rising edge will be the positive. Positive edge, or falling edge, which is the negative edge. The JK flip-flops, these ones eliminate this flip flop, eliminates the state when we say they are not allowed, the states which are not allowed of R equal to S equal to 1. So if you use a JK, you will be able to eliminate that, and this is by use of two flip flops. And we call them a master flip-flop and a slave. I'm going to change this word in my next electronics course. I will call it a boss and employee instead of a master slave. It sounds very colonial. So when I'm teaching this course next time, I won't talk of a master slave. I'll talk of an employee. But it is called a master slave, a master flip flop, and a slave flip flop. The people who use these things sometimes they have to look for examples that can explain things easily. And we've continued to do that because if you were in the United States or if you were in the United Kingdom, it is easy for you to know what a slave does. He's a slave, he walks around carrying the master's things. My When you are here, when you talk on this level, you get noisier.
So it wouldn't be nice to continue using it.
So in the future, I will change this master and this level. So, but it makes the makes sense that you use two, three flops for one to be a master and then a slave. And the circuit symbol for Sarge, you have the JK, sorry, you have your outputs here, our complemented outputs, QQ bar, and then you have a block and your other. So you have the J, you have the K, and then here you put in your block. So the truth table is very interesting in that the truth table has a J input, K input, and block. Then we have the Qn plus 1. So we start with not connected, and you haven't switched on the clock. Then the first state is what we get. The second one is you haven't had any inputs on J and K, but you have activated the clock. And then you still at the same QN. The next one is, we go to the next ones of 00, 01, 10, and 11. And then we have our clock. Our clock can be able to give us when it is rising or falling edge, the rising edge or falling edge. But we say only output. The output changes only when we are at the rising edge. So we shall draw for the rising edge. How do we draw it? We draw it like this and put this arrow here. So we are only drawing a portion. And this portion is this one here. We are drawing this portion here of rising. And then lastly, on when it is 1-1, I draw the... like you are drawing an integral, but make sure there are corners on the bottom. So when you have 0-0-0, no J and K, nothing, but you have a clock this was just enabling the clock when you had just switched it on. This is when now it is at the rising edge. And then when that is the case, you are still at the QN. And then you don't put anything in J and K. You put K, you put 1. Then you get your 0. And then you put in J 1, you get 1. And when you have both of them activated, becomes the opposite of complementary to the one of 00 here, which is QN bar. And that's why we say that now at this point, with our JK, we eliminate the not allowed state. And so this is these ones here is the same as our J. If you look at them, the output is actually similar to our J. The last one on this part is the if you get tired, you tell me, we shall read the rest and I'll be glad to go. The last of the flops is the Tombow flip-flop. what has toppled in? Or what is an example of a topple, something, that's something that used to topple? You are now, you are millennials, so you don't know the cassette where you play and then pause. That is a toggle key. You are using the same button to pause the cassette or to make it play. When you are typing on your computer, now you don't, again, being millennials, you are, some of you have not used the keyboard at all. You are using things on, others even write on the screen when you use the Google keyboard. Just right there, like with the finger, then one is good. But the keyboard has a caps lock. You press the caps lock, it activates, you start typing in capital, you press the caps lock again, it goes into lowercase. That's a toggle key. And it uses this example. Number lock is also a toggle key. You press it, it activates number lock, numbers. You press it again, numbers disappear. You can't type numbers. So this changes state on every rising edge or falling edge. So if you are having caps on, when you press caps go on. When you have caps off and you press caps go on. So if off was falling, then pressing it now to make sure you change step. If it was high because you had put them on, pressing it now will make it low. That's what I mean by changing step. And that's how circuits of the keyboard, the calculator work. Simple circuits inside. And then they do a bunch of functions. When we are doing operation amplifiers, we were able to make an integration or an integrator which can do integration. We were able to do a differentiator. We had a sum circuit and a difference or subtracting circuit. You arrange those things, you put your numbers in, it gives you an answer. So you can imagine how people have suffered sitting down and doing these things, putting circles together, and for you are shouting way away. So we have our pulse, and if this is our clock, it means that we are having a change only. I mean either on the rising edge or on the falling edge. So we can have this one going up to here. Then we go to over here, we go on. Here was at the falling, is when we had change of state. Well, we had change of state at the rising, had the change at the another rising, or can have a change at the falling state, EDC. And this would be our output. Circuit symbol we have our rectangle, much as you didn't really agree with me which one is this figure. And then you have the complementary outputs, and then all you are doing is to put in the clock, the pulse for this toggle flip-flop, you are only putting in the pulse. In your free time, you can go look for the circuit and which gates you can use to implement the toggle. But I would prefer you start thinking hard and wondering how these guys did all this stuff. And then you get what we call the counters. Counters are clock sequential circuits. Dash are clock sequential circuits. And a modulo M all divided by M all divided by M counter M states. So an N bit binary, an N bit binary counter has about N flip flops. And divide by M, the M would be the same as N2 to the power N, being that it is, you remember the base 2, how we were changing from base 10 or base 4 to binary, where you have to make, if it is, if you have, for example, 12, 38, base 10, and you have to put it into binary. I don't remember exactly how to change the bases, but I remember we would say 1 times 10 to the power. I don't remember exactly how we would do it. That was when I was still teaching senior 1, the bases. How do we change from one base there? When I reached campus, I had a Casio calculator. I would change from any base to any base. Base 2, the base 8, opt is base 8, then base small is base 10. I wouldn't care about which one, but this is the 2 to the power n. I can't really recall the... Who of you is part-timing teaching senior ones and reminds us? And reminds us of how to change from this one to this base 10 to base 2. How do we do this? Yes?
It's not what you do, just divide that number while putting the remaining half.
I just divide this one by 2. So if this was base 2, which is impossible, like if I had 100101, and then I have it at base 2, and I want to make it to base 10, is when I would say 1 times 10, I mean 10 times 2, 1 times 2 to the power 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, let's see what this thing does. So this would be 5 plus 0 times, I think that would be 0, 0.
Yes.
And then 1 times 2 to the power 2. This is plus 0 plus 1. So this would be, to the power 5 is what? 32 plus 4 plus 1. This is 37. So you are saying 37 divided by, how was dividing that? No, is it like this?
No.
It's in 11. So I have 37.
Yes.
So then I do like how?
Yes.
I put a 2 here.
Yes.
So goes in.
Yes.
So you put divide here, you becomes 18 for 36, remainder?
1.
Yes.
That's
then I put in, it becomes 9. 2 here.
Yes.
9 Remember zero. So then, 3, 4. Then that? Then 2. Sorry. So I will have to write this one here, isn't it?
Yes.
But now I remember. It's been a couple of years, maybe about 15 years. This is when I told it. 2, 0. So then I have 2 years, 1, 0. So I had the 1 here. Add the 0, 1 here. And the 1. So this becomes a 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1. Is it the same?
Yes.
Ah, I've now managed to use you to remember my things. So, and the reason we say it's a binary device is that you are only using a high, low in a sequence, and after using that high, low, 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 whatever, in this sequence we are able to get a number called 30, that is 7, but when we are having these ones and zeros. And that means we make our life easy. We only need to have a high state, low state, high state, low state. So if we were using 5 volts, we would have a 5 volt at the beginning, 0 ground the second point, ground the third point, it's half 5 volts. So 1.5 volts would give us our state. But then get interpreted on the screen as 37. But when we were only using high, low, high, low, high, low. That's how big the electronics was. So the 8-bit binary counter, he can use any flip-flops. Remember, if we join a bunch of them, then we will be able to do these functions. Where we are having, for example, a 1, a 0, a 1, a 0, a 1. We only need to arrange our notes and the ands and ors so that we can get one signal like this, our 5. We put a note, it gives us a 0. We put another note, it gives us a 1 again, until when we have finished the sequence of our circuit. So this can give us m equal to 2 to the power n states. And these could be either 0 if n is equal to, then we have a 1, a 2, and so forth up to 2n minus 1, then 0, 1, 2, and so forth. We can have a repo counter. Repo counter, and this repo counter, e.g., if we had a 4-bit, we had a 4-bit binary repo counter. So an example, we can have a little bigger space for drawing all these things. So if we had a bunch of our flip-flops, have one flip-flop, another flip-flop, two of them, 3, 4, we have, it's a 4-bit, so we have 4 of them. So we enable, we have our clock, CLK, And then we have our complementary outputs. And then this complementary output gives us the next pulse. This other output gives us our lowest significant bit, which is our Q naught, our lowest significant bit. Then we go to this other side, we get our Q bar and our output. Our output here gives us Q1, and this one is fed in here to give us our clock. So this is Q bar, Q gives us Q2, this one here gives us our next clock. And then finally we get our Q, and this one becomes our Q3. This is Q, and this is Q. And then, since it is a 4-bit counter, you get this one as the most significant bit. Do you remember the significant figures? So if our clock was having this pulse, this pulse of this much frequency, one, two, three, four, five. I should be having about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Doesn't matter. I'll be able to get this. I take the two of these, and then I take the two here. I'm replicating the one we had, either on the rising or on the falling, rising or falling, you can see. And this would be our Q naught. Our Q1 would take now the rising, falling, rising, falling. Make sure this one is exactly here. And the Q2 would now take the whole of the thing here, up to here. If you had made this smaller, then you can have a couple of them. And so on. Now this whole stuff now would be making us come up with a new dimension of dealing with what we call changing from analog to which we are already in digital. But now, in order to apply all these, we need to know how we can change our analog signals in digital signals so that we can do this business. And when we have this one, how do we change it into analog? And an example is, up to today, you cannot make a digital microphone. You have to talk into the microphone. You have to force the air to make the, you have to talk so that you use your sound to force the air to vibrate, and that air goes to the diaphragm of the microphone and cause the vibration, and you get the sound. And then it goes in the circuit and be recorded. Also, in order to enjoy music in your club or wherever you enjoy music from, you must make sure that this sound can go to the speaker, cause the diaphragm to shake, and then it also makes the air around to vibrate, and then your eardrums can start enjoying music and you start shaking around. So there is a possibility that you make sure that you can, I mean, you must make sure that at one point you have to change what is digital into analog, so that it is palatable. But the basis of changing from one point to the other is for comfort and efficiency. If I'm talking into the microphone, I have to change that sound into digital so that I can play around with it with the public address system and increase the sound so that the rarity can be addressed. So it means digital signals are easy to play around with. They are easy to repeat, easy to magnify, easy to replicate in any way. That is easy. That's why you have to have a microphone which goes in. Otherwise, you would be having a megaphone. We've lost a kid. If you have seen the kid on a megaphone, what you put in is almost what comes out. No processing. You've ever seen people with megaphones? Something which looks like this. It has something here. All. I don't know how they talk, what they talk to, but you hear the sound. And the Hajj use this megaphone for prayers.
They are those who normally go outside. They have started praying like pastor, making noise.
You should keep quiet until God.
In the same place.
And say, I want more knowledge. But if you shout, I want money, people look for you,
thinking you needed money.
Okay, so let's look at the digital, analog, and analog, digital. Digital, analog, and analog, digital. Converters. So digital analog is digital analog DAC. Analog to digital is ADC. You find this is impressions. If you have a digital TV, if you have like, I think all digital TVs are flat. If you have a flat TV, and it can give you options of digital. All you do, you go to setup, you go to channel on the part of scan or auto scan. When it gives you an options, you say anima. And when you choose anima, you go to the next one, you choose digital TV, DTV, and you throw away your decoder. You won't need any decoder because you can get about 34 channels of reset, which are free. You only need a menu, a signal. Then you can ditch the decoder of monthly subscription. So I was telling you about the advantages of digital processing. We have accuracy. Typewriter. You see, in the typewriter, when you typewrite and you have typed AA, accuracy, you have typed here AA, there's nothing you could do. You could only just look for a whitewash and whitewash 1A. Nowadays you can backspace or you can delete and remove the A, and that's how why we say accuracy in processing. But also, but if you were to calculate on a piece of paper, calculating the values, compared when you enter your values in a calculator, then it gives you a final value. And then flexibility. Also, flexibility falls in the category I've talked about, like of one document. Flexibility that you can now, you can even copy a whole paragraph, and if you thought, like if you are writing an article, and you thought that part should be the last paragraph, you just cut it, put it in the last part. And you can now have those, if you are trying to write a song, and you wanted to have a repeated stanza, they call it chorus. If you wanted to have a chorus, you don't have to type chorus all the time. You just copy, paste, like straight and straight and straight. So you have what we call the repeatability. And then also you have the ability to perform complex operations. With analog transmission, you don't have a transmitter, you have a receiver, an then the signal you send is the TV station you listen to or watch, for that matter. Nowadays, you have NTV Mobi, so you can watch on app or NTV. You can have NBS Mobi, whereby you can watch your NBS live on a smartphone. Because of the ability to perform some complex operation, you are able to configure that the signal from the camera in the studio goes to the transmission. After transmission, can also be watched online using the app. But also you can do a bunch of things. You can write a program which will draw your graphs in Matlab. You can have a bunch of, when I'm trying to process your marks, I can say this test was out of this and this was out of this. Then finally I say this cell here and this cell here added to this one. Then I get coursework. Then I get your exam changed to 60. And then I add, then finally I get the result. And I don't have to hassle adding this one. So I can perform complex operations. And an example of this, you can have an analog input like a keyboard. And then you change this analog to digital using a converter. And for example, use a CPU or simply call it a computer. And then we can have a digital output. A digital output. Or we can have actually a conversion back to the digital to analog conversion and come out with an analog output. So an example I said, like if you look at an example of a computer, keyboard here would be analog input. CPU, so the conversion happens, the CPU does, it helps you to do a bunch of other things. You can do, improve on the accuracy, you can have the flexibility, you can have the repeatability, you can have the ability to perform it. Once you have gotten the input, you can play around with it. But you can imagine for a cassette, when you record your voice on a cassette, which is analog, nothing you can do apart from recording on top of it again. But when you record on an iPod or directly to the computer using a microphone, then you are able to get the sound. You can check even where you were lousy, you can increase the part where the voice was low, you can chop off what you don't want. Like when I talk here and I'm saying something, like I say the president was, when I reach there, I chop off. So that if he is tempted to, if he has heard that, I normally say a lot of things about him when he's trying to, unless you can go the whole video, but it's not there. When does he say these things? Because I can do the manipulation there. And then you can change digital to analog if you are now going to play the music from a DVD player or from your subwoofers to the speakers. So the subwoofer, if it has a speaker, it's fine. But then nowadays, you see, you just get your card, slicing, or get your flash drive, push in, and you get your remote and start dancing immediately. The flexibility, you just have things on the palm of your, on the tip of your finger. So, what do we use to do the conversion? There are methods we use, and one of the methods, let me first see how much we are left with, so that we can agree on the time. It's a lot that we shall manage. So digital analog. I don't mind. When you are tired, you tell me we are done. I also have the tomorrow I'm not there, tomorrow I'm going to another general meeting. The shareholders. So it starts maybe at 9, maybe ends at 11, but I can't make it here so fast. So my programming of the course, I knew if you had not chased me on the other Thursdays and Wednesdays when you were away, I wouldn't be now wondering how much is left. Or if we were not going to do the course on Thursday, I'll finish very comfortable. But I still have Friday, that's why I'm comfortable. Isn't it? We are looking for a Friday. Utilize your fees. I am not corrupt. I cannot eat money for free. I have to work for it. So, one is, but don't you now accept that learning is a process? Each day brings a new style. Today, the way I have talked is different from how I talked on Thursday. Probably is going to be different how I will talk when we meet in the future. How I was talking, when I'm in the lab, I'm careful. When I'm here, I'm tight. That's what they call an experience in learning. So we look at the weighted resistor method as we how we try to convert from digital to analog, or analog and digital analog converter using weighted resistor method. Weighted meaning that we arrange the resistors in a given way. And if we can take, for example, a 4-bit digital to analog converter, then we will have our key reference, then we have our resistor R, then have a switch. Then another resistor 2R, we call them two, the weighted because of how they are arranged. They told me you are done with our process. So we will go up to 6. When? So what? You think when you say a tester, a Shiva or? This is 4R. You also have mine, so you have mine after tomorrow. And I have to ask everything that I will have taught by today. So I will upload the notes and make sure I ask up to the. And you see, we have to get a middle line. So if you show that you are busy, I can also be busy. Okay, so we have our weighted resistors, weighted meaning that this is R, 2R, 4R, 8R for a 4-bit. And then we have our feedback resistor here for our operational amplifier. And then we have our output, VR. We have the feedback resistor, we have IF, I0, I1, I2, I3. So S3, S2, S1, S0. So this is the most significant bit, and this other side here is the least significant bit for I0. Now if we switch on all the switches, all switches are closed, All switches are closed. Then we would have I naught plus I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus IF equals to. We say that this point here, we have nothing entering into the operation amplifier because of the golden rules. Input resistance is so high, output resistance is so low, hence giving us infinite gain. And then you can work out to find out that if we looked for I naught, I1, and I3, then we can come up with the expression that our V ref over AR plus V ref over 4R plus V ref over 2R plus V ref over R plus the other side IF is V out over RF equals 0. So our V out, or the value we could have gotten out, would be minus RF V ref into 1 over 8R plus 1 over 4R plus 1 over 2R plus 1 over R. In general, the switch Sn, can be represented by a bit. Can be represented by a bit. Bn, which is equal to 0 or 1. So we also write the weighted resistors as Ri equals to 2 to the power 3 minus I R. For I equaling to 0, 1, 3, and we can hence write our V out. V out is the operation that this kind of circuit would have done, which would be the same as minus RF over 2 to the power 3 R V ref summation from 0 equal 3 IB VR. So I will let you read about the R2R ladder resistor method, and then let you read about the analog to digital conversion using the flash or parallel converters, successive approximation method and dual slope method. We'll read about the priority encoder, and then dual slope in a gradient converter, and properties of converters. That will be the end of the course. So officially I can say I have finished teaching the course. Much as you have to read the part of, you now know why you are doing the digital to analog and analog to digital. I'll post the notes about digital conversion, the other detailed notes online. If you have any questions or any comments, you can hear them now or hear them on Friday. Otherwise,